the Olympic Winter Games on CBS. And now from Lazy Z, the 10-kilometer men's biathlon.
What if, on one of the most important days of your life, you failed? What if, 4 years later, you had a second chance? Today, America's Josh Thompson gets that second chance.
A trip to Les Saisies can easily seem like one that takes you back in time. For many of the people who live here, deal with their past by duplicating it every day. Many people who don't live such a life have a difficult time in balancing what was, what is, and what will be. This is Al Troutwig. Josh Thompson is such a person, and he competes for the United States in a sport called biathlon. Before we go any further, you might ask the question, what is biathlon? Good question.
It's just like cross-country skiing, except you carry a gun. Ski a little, shoot a little. 5 bullets for 5 targets. Entering the range, your pulse is 180. But if you're this fit, kick it down 30 beats. Then aim if you can. There's a time penalty for every missed target. Got it? Then do it again. There were more people watching today than there are biathletes in the United States. And of those 800 or so, Josh Thompson is the best. This is a day Josh had circled on his calendar for some time, when he can erase the bitter mental residue left from the events of a day almost 4 years ago. That was the day Josh Thompson was in fourth place with one trip to the range left in the 20-kilometer race. He missed 3 out of 5 targets, finishing 25th.
I did not enjoy the 88 games. And when you go to the Olympics and have a bad time, something's wrong. That won't happen again.
He felt too much pressure as a medal hope had weighed him down. So he took 2 years off, putting priorities where he thought they belonged, with his wife, Carolyn.
She has a look on her face of why me.
With his family support group in place, Josh took up flying, with the dream to be a commercial pilot very much alive.
No sport is more important than friends and family. It used to be for me, but it's not anymore. It's a silly attitude I had then. Other people have it now, and that's fine for them, but it's not my game anymore.
He had chosen this day to be one of the late starters, a critical decision, for by the time he took the poles forward, the temperatures were in the 40s, and Josh was skiing on slush. There is much that Josh downplays, but being committed when he races is not one of them. There are mental devices he uses to stay that way.
Have fun, have fun, have fun. And when you do it, you usually do a lot better anyway. When you're wrapped real tight around the axle, you can't let anything happen the way it should. You're always trying to force it and it doesn't work.
After 3.5 Ks and for the first of 2 trips to the shooting range, Josh skis in totally downshifted, trying to become totally calm so he could aim true. As they say, Josh shot clean. 5 bullets hit their mark. As he went back out into the woods, early starters were heading home. Mark Kirchner of Germany was one of those who fell at the finish with exhaustion, the price he paid for the gold medal. In Josh Thompson's second and final try at shooting, there was one miss. And in a race this distance, that meant an extra 150 meters of skiing. That 30 seconds or so was the difference between top 20 and where Josh Thompson finished at 32nd.
Josh, are you satisfied with the way things went today?
No, not really. Just was a little bit slow for my personal taste, thanks.
What made it slow?
That I don't know. If I knew, I probably wouldn't have been slow.
On Josh Thompson's calendar, another day is circled, proving this was a second chance and not a last one. That comes next Thursday in his specialty, the 20K race. 4 years to the day from the haunting memory of Calgary, he is driven to rise above.